Meningitis is an illness that can be very scary. It's an infection that can make people very sick. Babies who get the disease are at a particular risk of getting dangerously ill because it can be tricky to diagnose and symptoms can escalate quickly. More on how to recognize and treat meningitis from Mayo Clinic.
Very smiley, very happy kid.
That sums up little Jimmy Morse. But when symptoms of meningitis hit, he became very lethargic.
He had a very high temp, 104.5 under the arm, and he was making a lot of moaning noises and just was not with it and wasn't acting like himself. And he had a rash, like a little bit of a, like a reddish rash on his stomach.
Since Jimmy's a baby, he couldn't tell anyone if he had two other telltale signs of meningitis, headache and stiff neck.
Inflammation of the membranes, inflammation of the membranes around your brain and spinal cord.
Dr. Ritu Banerjee says meningitis can be caused by viruses or bacteria. Bacterial meningitis is more severe. The bacteria that cause meningitis typically live in our nose and airways. In rare cases, the bacteria can get into your bloodstream or meninges, which are the membranes surrounding the brain and spinal cord. Left untreated, meningitis can cause brain damage and even death.
So it's vitally important to get emergency treatment fast. Jimmy did. His parents took him to the emergency room where doctors diagnosed him with bacterial meningitis. He was admitted to the hospital and stayed for 7 days as he received IV antibiotics.
When Jimmy got home, he continued oral antibiotics for 5 days. Jimmy was very lucky. He recovered from a very severe case of meningitis.
I think it was even more scary when the doctors started telling us that he must be destined to do something in this world because most kids don't make it through.
Back to his happy self after battling bacterial meningitis. For Medical Edge, I'm Vivian Williams.
Dr. Banerjee says that the best way to protect against bacterial meningitis is for children and adults to get routinely recommended vaccinations. And to prevent viral meningitis, wash hands often. Don't share utensils. Do the same things that help prevent cold or flu.
Before we go, a brief look at the main stories. Opposition questions the adjournment of the 8th sitting of the House, and Speaker of the House declares a 9th sitting legal. Auditor General's report on the Seacow's Bay development project cites lack of transparency in government records. New Elmore Stout High School principal insists on equal access to education and love for learning. Virgin Gorda health officials say there is a dengue outbreak on the sister island. Government decides to move forward with the National Greenhouse Project. And Kristen Fraser shares her reaction to the news of Beyonce and Blue Ivy wearing her designs. In news from the Caribbean, upcoming Caribbean Tourism Conference to examine marijuana tourism. And selling crown land and privatizing major services are among recommendations made to Cayman Islands government. Remember, you can find all the news stories featured in this newscast as well as previous newscasts on our website, jtvlive.net. You can also watch this entire newscast on jtvlive.net, along with JTV's television programs, community and government events. Additional information can be found on our Facebook page, facebook.com/jtv55. Remember to like us, as well as our JTV News YouTube channel, where you can find all our news features, press conferences, and Spotlight's top news segment with Sean Rose. We welcome your questions and comments. Email us at jtvnews@hotmail.com. For Sean Rose and the entire news team, I'm Ino Soman. Thank you for watching.